been lucky enough to go to Canada, I think it's four times now, and really enjoyed myself there. And last year was the first time I toured the west coast of Canada. And it was great. But the last gig was in Vancouver. And this gig possibly was not a career highlight, I have to say. I can't remember now who recommended the venue to me. But I don't think they like me very much. So this gig was on officially the roughest streets in Canada, the whole of Canada. So rough, in fact, that despite the fact the hotel was a 2-minute walk from the venue, I still drove. That's how bad it was. The only people at the gig were four utterly fanatical banjo fans who'd driven miles and miles and miles. I couldn't believe how far they'd come for this gig. And then two other people who I think knew the promoter. And then a guy who wandered in, and I'm not sure he actually knew where he was, but anyway, he came in there. In all seriousness, the street, I say it's rough. I mean, it wasn't particularly scary. It was just more kind of sad, really, because Canada, if any of you've been to Canada, it's a great country, and Vancouver's an incredible city and everything, and it's an amazing place. But this street basically kind of contained all the people that had been sort of forgotten about. So you just wandered down the street, and it was just full of kind of zombified drug addicts, basically. And it was... It was quite sad. And I remember one woman in particular, she was wandering round and round this car park just for hours and hours and kind of making a noise, and you could tell she was trying to say something, but you know, she couldn't speak anymore, basically, and it was all quite sad. So I wrote this song about that. Thought it'd be a nice cheerful one to bring into the gig. Looking at the set list, it does get a little bit happier as we go along. But anyway, this is a song inspired by that street in Vancouver.
Saints, but the answers can't be found.